demands use of information technology for more processing, then the person already who is struggling and suffocating with the biotechnology should have advanced knowledge or additional knowledge in other two faculties also. So that is an extra demand. This growing convergence, apart from your faculty, by an interdisciplinary study. Interdisciplinary study is a little different. I want to give you a clear definition of cognitive technology, which I mean. Interdisciplinary study is a little different from fundamentality study. Find a fundamental spark or a fundamental spirit from which life sources, material sources, and knowledge processing sources, they emerge. That is our cognitive technology. Already emerged things are there. How to use between them for getting benefits is known as interdisciplinary study. So we have to, for example, to get a nano project, sophisticated nano project done, there are two possibilities. You should require a person who is skillful in nanotechnology, biotechnology, and infotechnology. Otherwise, you should have a team, like-minded, compatible team of three persons who can work together. But more than that, it is known as parallel emergence. What is it? Parallel emergence. In cognitive psychology, we say parallel emergence. See, somebody is in biotechnology, somebody is in nanotechnology. Both of them are working in nanobiology, for example. More than their joint working, if your person is having both the skills inside, a nano person also having knowledge in biology, if he emerges in something, it will be more innovative, more deep and apt. Coming from two different sources, the compatibility, understandability, and the environmental conduciveness, everything will be there. If it comes from the same mind, it is known as parallel emergence. A person knowing both the things, if the person emerges in a solution, that will be more appropriate. That will be having a lesser risk. So Dura Drishti is later vision. Aghata Drishti is deeper vision. Samagra Drishti is composite vision. This composite, deeper and all-round vision is only possible if the person has parallel emergence. How it is possible to have parallel emergence? Already the particular thing which you have taken is a struggle for you. You are fighting with the syllabus. How you are going to take the other things for common study? So that proves that unless you master cognitive technology, which will make your weightlifting championship just as easy and as facile as a feather blowing exercise, it is just a pakshadhana, a feather blowing exercise. Unless a person undergoes a training for at least 6 months or 1 year of his cognoability development skills, by means of which the person can handle all of these things, it is very difficult for a person struggling with one technology to have a similar idea of parallel emergence with the other connected technologies. Number one, recently in the areas where they can work together, I can give some projects as well as some exercises which can be just explained in the next session. Number one, now they have identified some fluorescent polymers in nanospheres. With these fluorescent polymers, they can clearly identify these metabolites. What are metabolites? That which are governing to be the reasonable faculties or reasonable factors for diseases and disease-causing environments inside the body. In the metabolic activities, they are known as metabolites. By means of this nanosphere fluorescent structures, that is the polymers, we can identify them very easily. By means of which, as these nanospheres and these fluorescent polymers, as they are parts of the biological assay, there is a biological assay, biological structure. As it is a part of the biological assay, they are non-harmful, they are precise, they deal with the extract morbid rosin, so that they can be very precise in diagnosis as well as treatment. At the time of diagnostic delivery, they will be precise. At the time of drug delivery also, they will be more precise. It is the use of polymers, fluorescent polymers of nanospheres. And second thing is, now we are having conjugation of natural antibodies which are there inside with nanoparticles. It is known as antibodies nanoparticles computational modeling, in which a particular antibody of our system can deal with one more nanoparticle, provided that there are two conditions. One is affinity, second is specificity. Affinity is both of them should mingle together, and specificity is they have to work for the common cause by means of a ligand bondage, that is known as reception ligand recognition model. Reception ligand recognition model. This is a model by which the mutual affinity between the antibody of the body along with that of the particular nanoparticle can be mingled together, which can be used for detection as well as treatment. And third thing is, now by means of the advanced bionanotechnology, they have invented immunodiagnostic bionanosensors. And fourth thing is, there is bio nano complex studies. What is bio nano complex studies? This biological matter and this nanoparticle matter, they must be understood with three factors. They are mixed with a covalent bond, the bond structure of an antibody along with the nanoparticle, creating a covalent bond which has three qualities. One is compatibility between each other, second is solubility in action, third thing is biodegradability. If it is not soluble, it is dangerous. If it is not degradable, that is also a dangerous hazard to body. So it should be compatible for becoming effective, for preventing from side effects. It should be soluble and also degradable. So this thing is produced in latest bio nano complex devices. And fifth thing is natural or inherent affinity. Naturally, God has created in such a manner that selected antibodies of the body are responding or recognizing selected nanoparticles. Naturally, it happens. So at the basic level, everything is having some sort of adherence and admiration naturally. Recently, they have made a research in nanobiotechnology lab of Southern California University, where the immune system of a mouse, a particular antibody that has proved its bond affinity of 25 nanometers with C60 furans. So this is also possible by means of mutual affinity. We are not uniting it. Naturally, at the basic level of the biological subtle matter and particle subtle matter, matter subtle matter, they have a natural bondage. At the time of our informative or intellectual subtle matter, they will have a bondage. So natural, this convergence of cogno, nano, bio and info is very natural, which we have understood after so many centuries. So this is something known as nano-bio convergence. And next, we are also having, apart from this, some information technology utilities like that of molecular dynamic simulation. What is molecular dynamic simulation? If a particular nanoparticle that occupies a selected minutest spot of an antibody, it occupies only a limited space, leaving a big area for interactive studies. There are various interactive behaviors and disciplinary studies in the vast area can be very effectively visualized and monitored in the study of the molecular dynamic simulations. Apart from which, in simulations also, information technology, it has very wondrously resulted into the minimization structure of 300 times. 300 steps of minimization has been recently done by people. So it is known as a deepened descent model and Newton-Raphson model. Recently, they have invented, before 1 year, two models which are known as Newton-Raphson model. Second is deepest descent model. In that model, you can minimize. How many times? You can minimize to the proportion of 300 times. 300 times of miniaturization is possible. And it is known as stochastic boundary molecular dynamics model. It is stochastic boundary molecular dynamic model. This thing has been now recently developed. And apart from that, in the complex system of bio-nano system also, there are two possibilities. One is the reception area. What is the reaction or reception area? And second thing is spherical reservoir area. And this is also, these two zones are differentiated into two regions. One is the region of reaction, second is the buffer region. And this atomic behavior by means of two dynamics. One is Langevin dynamics, second is molecular dynamics. Applying these two dynamic principles, the atomic structures of the first area, the first region, it is used for propagation. Propagation of signals, processing, everything, etc., image transmission, etc. In the second area, that particular element or the atomic behavior is retained by using harmonic restoring forces. So, some area in between the bio nano complex, there are two things to be done: propagation and retainment. If everything is propagated, there is no retainment, there is no use, because it will hold on everything. If everything is retained and not propagated, the signal processing cannot be done. So, by means of propagation, which is done by molecular dynamics, retainment of the essential factors by harmonic restoring factors is done by means of